welcome, 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 welcome to Master G's Theater. And I am your host, Master G. And of course, I'm joined by the best radio personalities in the world. CLB.
One love, CLB in the house.
DJ Boom.
I am present.
And
R.B.I.
What's up, R.B.I.? How you doing, feeling, brother?
Man, I'm doing pretty well today, man. Been busy as I don't know what, but I'm making it work. I'm making it work.
So, yeah. So, welcome to the show, everybody. Again, if you're tuning in regularly, thank you. If you're just tuning in for the first time, welcome. We talk about everything cool, everything fly, everything music, hip-hop, life, love, liberty, pursuit of happiness. And then we turn it all back around and do it with phenomenal style.
Yeah, I love it.
I don't
it.
Know how to follow that, but I have to let everyone know if there's if their style.
I'm feeling this ponytail today. I just want to be.
I love it.
The listeners can't see
it. I don't know if they can see this ponytail, but you guys have to realize.
It's what did
you
becoming. Call me?
Boom. Lovely locks. What
lovely
was it?
Locks. What was the last rocking one? The spots. DJ Boom's ponytail is fire right now.
It He's
is.
Lying. I don't have one. Okay, so check this out. Today, I swear I can't keep a straight thought going on. But one love.
Yes.
Let me just say one love. Because our guest today is the one and only Jalil of Whodini.
One of my favorites.
He is our inductee into the museum coming up here on August 26th in Atlanta at Atlantucky. And he is going to tell us all about how Whodini became one of the most important and groundbreaking hip-hop groups of all time.
And I know, and I have known them forever and a day. We go so far back, so it's going to be a real joy to speak to him. Every time I talk to him, it's an amazing thing. And of course, you know, rest in peace, X. Because
we'll talk about Ecstasy. Yeah. A.K.A. John Fletcher. But what do you guys have going on in your health segment today?
We got the good stuff, don't we?
We do. We have some really good stuff cooking. Guess where?
Where?
In the kitchen,
in
baby.
In the kitchen, baby!
So, yes. We're talking about nutrition today, right?
Yes, we are talking about nutrition. And like we always tell people, we're not experts. We're not certified.
Right?
We're just individuals who have experienced this thing. And we want to share our experiences.
Share the love.
Share the love. We don't want to spare the wealth. We want to share the wealth. We don't want to hide the love. We want to divide the love.
Oh, I thought you were going to say provide the love. But
yeah,
okay.
Let's do provide the
love. Provide, divide.
Speak on it.
Speak on it. And RBI, what you doing today?
And RBI is jacking for beats.
Jacking for beats. Yeah, man. We're keeping in house today. You know, a lot of times we do extended familial samples. You know, like Coogee Rap use something. We kind of go in that direction. But Whodini's one of the most sampled hip hop acts of all time. So we're gonna keep it in the family. Just go straight to a Whodini joint.
Nice.
Shout out.
But I'm not gonna tell you what it is though.
That's
shout
a good
out to
angle.
People that sample. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Keep the royalty checks
thank
coming.
Thank you, my family. Thank you. Yes, thank you.
Okay, well, after the break, I'm going to get your education on, or you're going to get your education on.
Yes, we are going to get our education.
Yeah, well, rest in peace to Pumpkin, because we're going to tell you all about the most amazing hip-hop musician and producer, possibly of all time. He's definitely very, very important. Pumpkin, rest in peace.
Okay.
But right now, and for the next few moments, the hands of God.
RBI.
RBI.
Take it away, RBI. When we will be back, stay with us.
Stay tuned.
I'm in it for the cash. It all comes down to the money. Whether it's rainy or snowy or sunny. Funny, but it all comes down to the money. I'm in it.
Say,
I'm in it for the cash.
I'm
in it for the cash. It all comes down to the money. Whether it's rainy or snowy or sunny. Funny, but it all comes down to the money. I'm in it. I'm in it for the cash. I'm in it for the cash.
I got a girl, but she's only mine some of the time. Cause some of the time she's hard to find. Especially when my pockets ain't looking correct. She ain't looking correct. She's hard to find, especially when my pockets ain't looking correct. She ain't looking correct. She ain't having no. When I was Jimmy, man, the inch would never end, and I had many friends, but I had many friends till the inch went spent. Now my girl is outie like Jenny, yo. She's only Jenna cause my dough was low.
The dough is low.
Now she's on the hunt like a little stunt. Whoa. Like a little stunt. Whoa. But the truth is kinda blunt.
It all comes down to the money, whether it's rainy or snowy or sunny. Funny, but it all comes down to the money. I'm in it for the cash. I'm in it for the cash. It all comes down to the money, whether it's rainy. You're sunny, funny, but it all comes down to the money. I'm in it for the cash, I'm in it for the cash.
It's like hard to find. And on the down low type of businessman, the type of businessman who doesn't really have a plan. Living kinda hard for a lot of his days. It seems that nowadays he has the phrase that pays. Seal it in the file as he calls it a dime. And it's good for a dime, but he don't call it a crime. Until he got knocked by the DEA. And now the DEA went and took the kid away. And now I never see him. Why he do a bit? Why he do a bit? Here's the real truth, kid.
It all comes down to the money. Whether it's rainy or snowy or sunny, funny, but it all comes down to the money. I'm in it for the cash, I'm in it for the cash. It all comes down to the money. Whether it's rainy or snowy or sunny, funny, but it all comes down to the money. I'm in it for the cash, I'm in it for the cash.
The more you get, the more you want. The more you get, the more you want.
Welcome back to Master G's Theater with me, Master G, CLB,
hey,
DJ
hey.
Boom, and R.B.
The R, the B, the I.
Keep it rolling.
Oh, my God.
I love.
I'm like so distracted by how dope RBI is.
I was almost tempted to get up and start, but I don't have those skills. And then the RBI back here, man. I'm going to throw this microphone at him.
Turn around my chair.
Man, I kind of feel like the more he cuts up on our show, the more right. we enjoy it.
That's what I'm saying.
Yes. I'm hoping the listeners like it as much as we do.
Look, you got to be borderline crazy not to be feeling this.
Can I tell you something real quickly, speaking of RBI?
Okay, tell me.
He DJ'd at the Smithsonian's National African American History
That's
and Culture
right.
Museum.
Oh, you did that
for their
gig?
Very first hip hop block party.
Oh, you did
That's
that gig
what's
last,
up.
Last.
And he DJ'd along, RBI DJ'd alongside J. Period,
wow.
Bun B,
wow.
Roxanne Shante,
Whoa.
Spinderella.
Wow.
Dope.
Am I
dope.
Missing anyone?
Dope.
There's a lot of people.
And he tore it up.
But no,
he had a good time.
Not only did he tear it up, but he's tearing it up like there in the go. Shadow of the Washington Monument.
Which is crazy.
And this beautiful African-American History Museum.
Beautiful
the building place. Itself is beautiful.
Yeah, beautiful.
Yeah.
The, place, the building
yeah.
is amazing, yes.
So let me tell you, I think they realized at the very last moment, oh, my God, it's a security situation. We can only do invite only, I think, or something. But it was me and some of the most influential folks in the city. They clearly knew who to invite.
Yes, absolutely.
And RBI just burnt it up with
That's what's up.
With Priest and Nomad. Shout out Priest and Nomad.
Okay.
And both of them are DC hip hop royalty. I just want to say that.
DC hip hop.
DMV.
Appreciate that, brother.
DMV.
It's a fact. These are just facts I spit. Okay. Speaking of facts I spit.
Yes.
I also like to educate people.
Yeah.
In a segment. That we call.
You must learn.
All right.
Learn. Rest in peace to the one and only Pumpkin.
Oh,
what
yes.
an amazing producer. Sure. He passed away many. Years ago, 1990 on this date, okay? But as Master G knows, he was incredibly influential to
yes.
the very first and most important hip-hop songs, okay?
Yes. Yes.
And he worked with early acts like Grandmaster Flash and the Furious Five,
yes.
Spoonie G, Treacherous Three, Funky Four, Grandmaster Caz, the Fearless Four, Dr. Jekyll, and Mr. Hyde was his,
wow,
you know, his group. But here's what I want to do real quickly.
Shout out to Andre Harrell.
Oh my God, Andre Harrell
Good
was, you know, was Dr. Jekyll.
Yes.
Right. So yeah. Dr. Jekyll, Andre Harrell started as a rapper named Dr. Jekyll.
Yes, people don't know that.
And they were produced by Pumpkin.
Wow.
Okay. And so I want to go through some of these songs that he produced that were the most important songs to this day in the history of hip-hop.
Okay.
Produced by, again, Pumpkin. Okay. So, Rappin' and Rockin' the House, Funky Four plus One More.
Wow.
On Enjoy Records.
That very, was before, very, that was very, before they went to Sugarhill.
Right?
Mm. Okay.
But also, that release, that single, very important song, as was Love Rap by Spoonie G.
Spoonie G.
Now I'm going to start kicking it up a notch.
Okay, go.
Body Rock.
Whoa.
Treacherous 3. Okay, I'm going to knock, kick it up another notch.
Go, go.
Feel the Heartbeat
Whoa.
By Treacherous 3.
Whoa. All before they came to Sugarhill.
Okay, so there's many other songs that he's produced. Okay, songs like You Rock for the Fantasy 3, songs like Put Your Boogie in Your Body by the Treacherous 3.
Wow.
He also did Problems of the World Today by the Fearless 4.
Ooh, that was a record, boy.
Okay, he did Dollar Bill Y'all by Jimmy Spicer.
Wow.
He did... Oh! Rockin' It by the Fearless Four, their biggest single.
Yes.
Rockin' It. Rockin' It.
Yes.
And then, sadly, like at the end of his career, you know, he started to come out, you know, like with his own stuff.
Okay.
So he put out, you know, himself, Pumpkin and the All-Stars, Here Comes That Beat. And it was a big record, a big, big record. And then there was another one. He put out like...
There you go.
Yeah, there we go.
There it is, yeah.
And then he put out King of the Beats. After that,
yeah,
and he passed away.
Oh. Wow,
so sorry to hear that.
Quite a legacy, yeah.
Yes,
and he also just side note, because Grandmaster Caz, you know, works with us and will be hosting the induction ceremony.
August
26th.
August 26th. That I am the executive director of and will be co-hosting.
Right. I didn't know Mr. Bill. So Mr. Bill by Grandmaster Caz was produced by Pumpkin. I wasn't even aware.
Oh, okay.
But rest in peace to Pumpkin.
Rest
you
in peace.
Are hands down one of the most important hip-hop producers and musicians in the history of the genre. We honor and remember you.
We honor and
at
remember
this time.
You. And send our love to your loved ones.
Yeah. So when we come back after this break.
After.
We are going to move from your colon to your mouth. Okay, wait. That's not the right way to say that.
Woo!
I mean nutrition. We're going to be working on nutrition.
Yes.
I'm going to.
Master G's
my segues says, need a lot of work.
Yeah, you need to you pull yourself together.
Wow. Going to.
I want to go back to the
I'm gonna rewind
ponytail,
that one.
I'm going to leave it alone.
Oh, the back to the ponytail. This is my punishment for the whole show. DJ Boom Schmagal.
Boom, 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 boom. No. So, yes, we're going to go. We're going to switch gears and get into Master G's Wellness Sense and do nutrition with CLB and myself. When we come back from the break, stay with us. It's going down. We're having a good time right here. Master G's Theater.
Peace.
Rest in peace, rest in peace, rest in peace, rest in peace.
Try.
hot to dry. I give you what we got, make you clap, snap, rock to the rhythm a lot. Say punkin' makes the beat, stand up for love class. And I rock the mic with the badge of my task. They call me Mr. T, just a funky beat. Make a cripple man walk, a blind man see. I make the dumb man talk, make a deaf man hear. Mr. Troy, this can fool me, rapping a career. Punk it, and it broke it down. I added some words that made it funky sound.
And we're back. It's Master G's Theater, and I'm telling you, we're having a wing dinger here, y'all.
Yes, we are.
Oh, yeah? Wing dinger? Hum dinger?
Yeah.
Well, wing dinger? What's the difference between a wing dinger and a hum dinger?
What you're doing at the time?
Yeah.
So, we are about to get into.
They say you are what you eat. So I strive to eat healthy. My goal is life. Be rich and wealthy. Cause true wealth comes from good health and wise ways. We got to start taking better care of ourselves. Be healthy, y'all.
Be healthy, y'all.
And So,
today what we're talking about with Master G's Wellness Sense,
yes,
we're touching on nutrition.
Yes.
Right?
Yes, we are.
Talk to us.
So the thing that people don't always put into the equation, you know, it's like, oh, I got to work out. And they don't really realize one of the most, it almost is like side by side. If you put a ton of energy and effort into working out, you have to put that same effort and energy into your nutrition. What you put into your body is what helps your body become what you want your body to be.
Exactly. And I've heard it said several times, many times, that the six pack happens in the kitchen.
That's 100% true.
Yeah.
That's 100% true. You have to understand that. Huh? You have to get the right protein. You have to get the right carbohydrates.
What?
The good fats as well as bad fats. You have to understand what your body could absorb. Like,
yes,
some people's body can absorb a high amount of fat and other people's can't do it. Because what happens, whatever your body does not use for energy or to build muscle or to give you energy, it stores.
As fat.
And it turns into fat. And that's a lot of times what happens when you're, you know, looking at an area or a region that you're like, I don't understand, you know, why I can't get rid of this. You know, let's say I got a little bit too much on my waist, or I'm not as lean as I want to be. A lot of times it has to do with what you put in your body.
Most definitely.
Yeah, and then the thing that people must understand is that everybody's body is different.
Mm.
See, that's the thing.
I was thinking the same thing just now.
Hey, girl.
We each have a different chemical makeup.
Yes.
So our bodies respond differently to different situations.
Totally.
So, for example, if a, in quotes, low-carb diet works for one person,
sit,
doesn't mean it's going to work for you.
Sit.
So guess what? We got to listen to our body.
Sit.
Learn
sit.
Oh, wait, hold on.
Let the church say amen.
Let me get my kerchief,
there
right?
It is, yeah.
Yeah, we've got
say
to listen to our own body.
Yes.
Learn what it burns.
Yes.
Ooh, did I just?
You just hit
just
it. That's a Master G Wellness Sense.
Is
you
it
need
your
to put
influence?
That in the bank. You got to put that in the bank. What'd you say now? Say it again.
Learn how it burns.
Learn
baby.
How it burns. Put that in. Give me a
spit
coin
that
on
knowledge.
That one.
Spit that knowledge.
Yes. And the other thing is, don't base your results on somebody else's results.
Facts.
You know, sometimes men's body changes, or men's bodies develop a lot faster sometimes than women's body.
Mm-hmm.
So, and then two women's bodies. You know, you might have one woman's body who's, you know, their metabolism works for them amazingly, and then you have a slower person whose metabolism is a little bit slower. You must, again, it's a unique situation. Everybody, even though we have the same body parts, we don't have the same body parts.
Makeup.
Yes.
It's the makeup,
yes,
right?
We're not all made the same way. Everybody is unique in their own way, shapes, form, and existence. So you have to experiment. The key is to experiment.
Exactly. And my admonition, encouragement, however I can phrase that, is read your labels. Because even when we believe we are, in quotes, eating more healthy,
mm-hmm,
what's making up the food that we're consuming.
Or if it says organic on the front, still right. Read that thing.
Right.
And quite frankly, if it's packaged, it's processed.
It's anything, 95.5% of food that has that is packaged, that is sitting somewhere, there's some sort of processing thing that happens. So they just got to put that into the equation.
Right. So the whole point of us doing this and sharing these wellness coins every week is for longevity too.
That's the
not
thing.
Just physical appearance, it's how our body is functioning from day to day. Is it, are we adding life or taking away life?
How you are transitioning into the twilight of your life. That's the key.
I like that.
Yes.
The twilight.
The twilight of your life. So the Master G's wellness sense for today, the money that you're going to put in the bank is to treat your body as just that. It's your body. So your experience is only unto you when it comes to food, fitness, nutrition, supplements, everything. Don't always believe what everybody else is doing. Take inventory on what's happening with you and what you do.
Indeed, our body is a temple and we treat it as such.
Absolutely.
Yes.
My body's a temple. And I am Khufu, the pharaoh.
With my favorite pharaoh.
Listen, Khufu.
Yes.
We don't have unlimited time.
Oh, okay. So let's keep it moving.
Keep it moving, Khufu.
So that's our wellness. That's Master G's wellness sense.
Yes.
That's our fitness thing. And we got to keep it rolling.
All right.
Keep
it going. Well, listen, right after this break.
Yes.
We have on one of the most important, innovative, legendary hip-hop rappers, musicians in the history of America. His name is Jalil. He's arguably, one-third of the legendary group Whodini.
Wow.
Please stay tuned.
Please.
We're going to spin like one amazing song from RBI.
Oh.
And we'll be right back.
Okay. Don't go nowhere.
Stay tuned.
Don't you go.
Please.
Don't you go nowhere. Don't you go nowhere. Don't you go nowhere.
Bandmaster D, if you please. Be yourself. I'm not rocking this jam to insult nobody. This one goes out to the carbon copies. So take a stand as quick as you can. If your plan ain't working, then change that plan. If you wanna be a loser, that's up to you. Just don't be a loser around me and my crew before you find yourself picking up yourself. Grandmaster D, if you please. Be yourself. I'm not rocking this jam to insult nobody. This one goes out to the carbon copies. So take a stand as quick as you can. If your plan ain't working, then change
rest
it.
To be.
If you wanna be a loser, that's up to you. Just don't be a loser around me and my crew before you find yourself picking up yourself with no one to blame besides yourself.
Be yourself. You got to be yourself.
There's a rumor being spread about me and the crew, about something we did or supposed to do. You might not have heard it, or maybe you have, but when I first heard it, all I did was laugh. I used to get angry and all uptight, but you can say what you want to spell my name right. Cause all I'm ever guilty of is rocking the house, but that's not what the rumor was all about. There's a rumor being spread about me and the crew, about something we did or supposed to do. You might not have heard it, or maybe you have, but when I first heard it, all I did was laugh. I
big mouth.
Tight, but you can say what you want to spell my name right. Cause all I'm ever guilty of is locking the house. But that's not what the rumor was all about.
A big mouth.
And then tell all your friends. And if you don't make it till you see me again, this
big mouth
can hear from the horse's mouth. And right then and there, we can straighten it out. Because I don't get involved with he said, she said.
A big
my advice is quit while you're ahead. Because one day I might not laugh, but then your mouth might check.
A big mouth. You got a big mouth. A big mouth.
Say,
a big mouth, a big mouth.
People used to say that you had a big mouth, and now I understand what they're talking about. Because what we do is just between me and you, not something that you run and tell your crew. But you had to tell Sharon, and she told Carol. Then the story rolled on just like a wheelbarrow. Carol told Dee Dee, and she told Pam. And Pam was so.
Aw, yeah, welcome back to the tantalizing sounds of RBI getting down. And the Master G Theater with RBI and DJ Boom. And we keep the show going!
Oh, my God. Well, let me tell you, we're going to keep the show going in a segment that we call Power Moves.
Yes.
So here we go, RBI. We have one of the most legendary and important, innovative hip-hop MCs in the history of not just hip-hop. He is one of the most important musicians in the history of America. Jalil of Whodini, are you with us?
What up, Ja?
What up, Ja?
Hey, Ja. I just have to get very personal and just say, this right here is a very special moment for me because it's you and it's me, and you know, Ja, you know how far we go back.
Yeah. That's for me and you.
Okay, Ja. Okay, all right. Welcome to the show, man. Thanks for doing this, man. This is so great.
One love, G. It's a pleasure.
Always. You know? Yes.
You know, Jalil, having you on our show is extra special because in like a little over a week, we are going to be inducting you and Whodini into the world's first hip-hop museum, the National Hip-Hop Museum. Please just tell us a little bit from your perspective, you know, what it means to be at this point receiving that type of accolade.
Oh, man.
Ja.
I don't even know how to explain it yet, you know. For it to come this far, for the hip-hop to have a museum, and to be placed in it, you know.
You deserve it, man.
These are not thoughts that were in my head in the beginning. You feel me?
Yeah.
So right now, I'm just absorbing it all, really, you know?
Well, what was in your head in the beginning? Like, did you, when you first got into hip-hop, did you start rapping or breaking or DJing?
No. actually, it was just rapping first, you know. I used to DJ a little bit, but the mic did it first. Really, it was just writing a rhyme that made sense. It was writing something that nobody had heard anybody rap on before, or to make that topic that extreme. And then when it comes to getting on wax, wow. That was a whole different thing, you know. It really kept the same elements. I wanted to be able to write something that nobody else had written before. I wanted to make something airtight where, you know.
Well, you definitely
guys
did that.
Come out the next week, the next month, the next year with the same topic and bust my ass. Feel me?
Yes.
Well, what made that's really competitive of you to like listen to everything that's out and go, you know what?
I can do better. And you did.
I have to admit it.
Even though I was putting them out, you was coming back with the jamming, slamming jammers. Ja.
Yeah. You know, my partner Ecstasy, man, may God bless his soul.
Yes.
You know.
Yes.
He was extra life given to me, you know. Actually, I felt back so when he came on, you know. It was cool, but look who we had to compete against, man. And we was from Brooklyn. So everybody getting those, the big breaks coming in was from uptown, Queens, Bronx, Manhattan. It was very little from Brooklyn, outside of Super Rhymes.
Right.
When Super Rhymes hit the wax, you know. He was out there in Brownsville where I used to live at one time. But I was down in South Brooklyn in Gowanus, you know, GP Rock, Baby for Life.
Wow. And
but who were you listening to that even made you want to write? Like, what MC particularly made you want to write and then rap?
I like the cohesiveness of Hollywood when he started making rhymes.
Yes.
Remember, when everybody first started, they could say what they want. But when everybody first started rhyming, it was all short rhymes uptown.
Right, Right.
You no know, long, it was yeah. four. It was four bar rhymes. Then yes, yes, y'all, and yes, yes. But the DJ wanted his credit.
That's right. That's
he,
right.
You be rhyming, and the dude just come off beat, so you could say, "Yeah, we got so-and-so on the wheels," you know. when he seen the MC getting too much light, that's what all the DJs did—they jiggy or something out of context. So to throw you off, so you have to stop and give him some recognition. Then the long rhymes came into play.
It went from very short to very long rhymes. How did it go from one extreme to another, Master G?
I wonder what.
Master G answered that. He know that too.
No, I'm listening to you, man. I mean, hey, you know the deal. We was doing it in the parties over there in Jersey, but y'all was doing it over there in the city. So, I mean, you know the deal.
Yeah, Brooklyn had their own thing, like, right. You know. Brooklyn had, you had to keep somebody entertained, man.
Right.
You might get beat up in a park in Brooklyn that day, you know?
Yeah.
Everything in Brooklyn led to getting beat up.
Hey, I'm from Brooklyn, and I can attest to that. It's actually true. How did you meet Ecstasy?
Me and X was in, like, he was in another group, like, two blocks up from where we was at. We rivaled them one time. But when I was making the tape for Mr. Magic.
Shout out to Magic.
I was rhyming with two younger brothers, with Diddy Vance and Chili G, you know. I was really a soloist because I didn't like carrying no equipment, man. Yo. I meet y'all at the party.
Wow.
But, you know, and they was chasing girls almost at that time, man. We were supposed to go make the tape. I'm telling everybody, yo, I get to do my work. You know, I'm straight out there for a while. So my work is definitely my bond. And the guy kept chasing the girl, so we waited an hour and she showed up. And, you know, he playing the role like he was. I'm like, man, you've been looking for this girl for an hour, man. You better talk to her. You better, yo, don't put me out there like that. Then they went upstairs for a little bit. Then I came upstairs and I'm like, yo, we gotta make that tape. Well, you know, we're gonna nail that shit easy. And all this. And I went downstairs and waited. And this guy walked by and see me sitting on the bench alone. And I started telling him about why I was sitting on the bench alone. And he's like, yo, that dude up in Wyckoff named Ecstasy got a hell of a voice, man. I was like, them dudes? Man, I'm not gonna do that. Ain't putting it down like us. But the dude that told me X's voice, he was a boxer. It shocked me because he referred me to somebody. He didn't give a shit about rapping. You feel me? So, it made me go check him out. And the short version is that night we put the tape together.
What happened to the other two guys he was rapping with?
They took too long that night, man. You know, so...
What was the very first thing y'all recorded, do you recall?
Yeah, it was the promo. I've been trying to find it on the internet, but I guess not. And I guess whoever had a tape of Mr. Magic back in 1980...
Wow.
You know, it's not alive, maybe, or something like that. It was off of SWAT. It was their first intro ever for a DJ on the radio.
Right.
Like the So and So Rocks at 6 o'clock or any rap intro. We made the first one, man. Off of SWAT. That was Magic's intro. When I brought it up to him the next night, because I missed that night, but I did. Bring it up to him the next night. He played it right there on the ear, man.
Yeah, man.
He gave it to him. He played it. He's like, yo, this is fresh, man. This is fresh. I'm playing this tonight. I'm like, tonight? Oh, shit. Let me call everybody and wake them up. It wasn't no cell phone. You know, dude wasn't home. He didn't get the message. There wasn't even no peepers yet.
So I'm assuming that promo just caught. No, you tell me. What happened? How did you go from the promo to a group?
New York City loved that promo. It was me, X, and his brother at first. New York City loved that promo, man. Magic must have played that for a year before he started playing some other stuff, you know? He did a challenge, you know, for people to come give up their promos. And nobody, I was really angry because I was angry. I thought the way about it because I didn't want nobody to do us, you know, take ours down. But if 3 or 4 months worth of tapes, nobody did it exactly like we did it or had that impact. He played some other cast tape, but it wasn't as long as our play. Like, he played ours and then featured theirs. And that's what hit me. Like, whoa. We made a tape that New York can't do it better. It started letting me understand that I understood styles and how to make something just the right length and put the right element to something, you know?
Yeah.
Most everybody that came after us had a bad solo, and we understood the mission.
You definitely did that.
So connect the dots. So everybody loves this promo. They're airing it on radio. The whole city loves what you, Ecstasy, and his brother did. And then how does the group come? How does the deal come? What happens next?
It's still on form yet. It's like a year goes by. But let's say 6 months, 7 months into it, 6 months or something like that, we do get an offer from Sugarhill Gang because Magic's close to Sugarhill Records.
You tell me something.
I don't know. We get an offer from Sugarhill Records. I said Sugarhill Gang. And
you're going to take my place, Ja? You did a better, much better job than
that. No, I couldn't do that, man. You was getting dressed 2 or 3 times a show. I didn't like that.
Ja, don't tell on my business on the radio, Ja. Don't tell on my business on the radio.
But you didn't take that deal. You didn't take that offer.
No, we didn't because Magic had some guy. He was trying to bring in the group. I think his name was Mike G or something. From Harlem. You know, sometimes you meet somebody and they don't like you, and you don't really like them. You really ain't got no reason. You just don't like each other. Your style, your spirits are different.
Yep.
Yeah.
Well, that's what I felt about this guy. You know. And from the beginning, we didn't rhyme long to make rhymes long. We did rhymes to... All right, that's your solo. But if we write something else going along with something, it's about whose voice or who sounds the best at doing it. And about everybody in the group need a 16-bar solo. Let's make the project. Instead of everybody trying to get the solos off for 16 bars and you have cats repeating the same thing. But anyway, I ain't like the guy. The guy didn't like me, so I ain't like the guy. and he was rhyming a long solo with it. And I was like, nah, man, that ain't what we're about. He's like, yo, you going like this guy, man, Harlem loves him. And I'm like, why is he here if Harlem loves him? We don't even know this dude. We're from BK, you know? I don't care what he's doing, Harlem. And he's like, yo, you this man because my flow is better than yours. Then why you here? You over here trying to intrude on our party. We don't even know you. You know, all you want to do is get a little name and leave. I said, and I don't want to be down with that, you know. I said, yo, just send me my publishing, man. You can have this group. I don't like it. I'm out. And Magic was like, what? Yo, everything got to be your way. I said, nah, it ain't always got to be my way, but it ain't always got to be somebody else's way either. Y'all take the record. He's like, yo, it's going to blow up, man. I'm like, yo, doesn't it blow up? I don't like them. And I don't, you know. I don't really want him down. Because, look, man, if he was that dope, he'd be doing his own damn thing.
Right.
Why you over here with somebody you don't know that don't even live around you? We don't even know you. We don't have nothing familiar. You know, we don't even like the way you dress.
We ain't talking about him these days, I'll tell you that much.
That's for sure.
You know, and I left, and I told X and his brother to stay, man. You know, you want to get on, man, you know, I'm giving you my permission. There ain't no love lost, man. Stay and do your thing. And I broke out. I was like, man, I'll see you Thursday. And so, and I got down like a block and a half, and all I know is X and his brother was like, yo. Yo, man, what happened? They're like, oh, man, we left too, man. Can't go back around the way, man, with a deal, and you brought us up to the deal, and we on and you not on. We don't like that dude either, man. I mean, you made a lot of sense. You know why he over here if he's so nice, you know? Blah, 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 blah. And I'll say, yo, as long as we sit together, can't nobody stop us.
That's right.
Let's bounce. And we walk like we was in a Shaft movie down to the train.
Right.
I need 50 cents to get on this train. You got me? Yeah, I got you.
But Ecstasy's brother didn't end up in the ultimate group. So what happened there?
So that might have been, so let's say we bucking in the 81 now. And Magic gets a call and he's going to WBLS.
Right.
They wanted, you know.
I remember that.
Particularly on that, the music program his daughter used to listen to Magic at. She was up late at night, so her mother was the music programmer at WBLS, so she started staying up listening to Magic with her daughter. Then they turned Frankie Crocker on.
Yep.
And they seen that's where the streets was at that time, so they gave Magic a deal.
Yeah, I remember when Magic moved to BLS. That was huge. It was huge when that happened.
It was the first time a radio...
Yes.
Pirate station, and it was the first time hip hop made major radio.
Yes,
hip hop was on pirate radio stations, you know.
Right,
that was the first time. Like, yep. A radio DJ did it. You know, they played the break, they played Sugarhill Gang, they played Rapper's Delight, they played the Message. Well, the Message wasn't even out yet.
Not that time, no. But no, yeah,
so we had Planet Rock, we had Rapper's Delight, Planet Rock,
Eighth Wonder.
Yeah. Eight Wonder, and was the Breaks? The Breaks was out by then.
Breaks was out by then. Yep.
Yeah. Those was our national hip hop records.
That's right.
That's it. Yep. Wasn't nothing else going national. That's it.
Yep. You're right. And to y'all.
Wasn't nothing else being played on major radio. That was it.
Yeah. It was Sugarhill Gang, Curtis Blow, and Grandmaster Flash and the Furious Five. That was it at that time.
Yeah. Well. And flashing them, but the Message wasn't even out.
No,
yet.
It was Freedom. It was right. Freedom. Freedom.
Right, right. But did Freedom go national?
Yeah. But it was not as, it wasn't as big, of course, as like Birthday. Well, Birthday, you had Freedom was out and then Birthday and all of that. But, you know, of course, the Message made their staple. But, you know, Curtis was out already with the Breaks and Christmas Rap. And then, of course, we had, you know, Rappers Delight, Eighth Wonder, and all that kind of that thing going right. on at
and,
the time.
And Soul Sonic Force.
Soul Sonic Force was out then, yes. Yes, that's right.
Yeah, that was our bang. So, Magic called me at the house and told me, yo, chill. We going to WBLS, you got to come up here. I'm like all excited and stuff like that. Then he said, yo, chill. We got a record deal. I'm like, huh? So we got a record deal, a company from London, and this and this and that. I don't even know if our friend's washing up now. Get out the house. Cool.
Who said that to you? Ecstasy said we got a deal?
No.
Magic.
Magic said.
Yeah, Mr. Magic.
Yeah. Maybe I'm speeding up too fast. I didn't want to take too long.
So right when Magic went to BLS, he somehow got y'all a deal?
No. I used to work with Mr. Magic at WB.
Yeah.
At HBCU.
Yeah, John and Magic, and they were all like in the same together. They moved over there to BLS.
Right. When the group got denied for the, left that record and stuff, me and Magic still worked together.
Right.
You know, from the day I brought him up that tape, we worked together. So we stayed together, you know.
And then the deal came with the London thing, right?
Right. When I came up to BLS, and I mean, I came up to HBI. I'm like, let me hear the record.
And then y'all went over there.
Heavy up, man. And so on, so soaked with the Furious Five were coming down to get it.
Right.
I'm like, huh? The Furious Five? I said, so we had a record deal. You know, that's your favorite group. I'm like, what you mean? I'm my favorite group when it comes to getting put on.
Right.
You know? Wow. You know, we had some words, and I was leaping. I was like, yo, man, people right here near you, and you forget them, man. I've been down here with you a year and a half, and blah, blah, blah. Don't get up, man. Don't get up. You get up, I'm gonna bust your ass, man. I swear to God, bro. You know, this ain't no sweet shit, boss. I really was fired up, and he was like, yo, chill, I ain't even know, I had left, so he came outside, yo, chill, man, I ain't paying attention to that's what's wrong, you ain't paying attention to the people closest to you, man, I'm there for you, and he was like, yo, man, come get the shot, I ain't chasing after you, I got a record on the turntable. Come get the shot. I said, that's all I wanted, just a shot.
You wanted a shot,
huh? I came up to it, got the tape, and went in the next room, start trying to figure out how to write this pop stuff, and the Furious Five has come in there. I'm already, you know, shaking in my leg pants and shit, like, yo, Furious Five, blah, blah. Well, it's like, I don't do what they do, and I ain't going to win going to do what they do. So I got to try to find another way to make this come off. And I chose the pop story way, like, because the record felt pop, you know?
What was the record?
What was the record?
Magic's Wand.
Magic's Wand.
Wow.
Right. Mr. Magic's first record about him and our first record.
Yeah. Wow, man. Hey, look, we could do
Jalil,
this.
Jalil, I feel like we could talk right. with you for like hours.
It's like you have so many stories. Like even when we talk, Ja, I mean, like literally we could be on the phone for hours. You know what I mean? Because there's just so much information between you and me and everybody else, you know, like all the stuff with Furious and then, you know, everything that was going on in the Bronx and everything was happening in Brooklyn and everything was happening over at Sugar Hill. It's crazy.
Yeah. So let me end this first verse. This long version. So, approximately a year later, six months, that night, I got the deal. Melly Mel told Magic, you ought to listen to your man more, and he gave this deal to me. I was like, oh, shit, Magic. Like, let me hear it. You made the Furious Five throw the tape. I'm like, I ain't made nobody do nothing. He just wanted to give me a shot. He liked the way the style was, so. I probably hadn't seen Ecstasy like in 6 months. So I laid the track down in the studio, and then the next day we was coming to do backgrounds, and I wanted to repay them back. So I called this house, the phone was off. I ran like 17 blocks from Washington Avenue down to Whitecroft. You know, I'm a fit young brother, you know what I'm saying? And go knock on his door. I'm sweating like a pig, and he opens up the door, yo, John, what's up? I'm like, yo, I got a record deal. He's like, what? I'm like, yo, I'm late for the studio, man. I ran all the way down there. Your goddamn phone is off, man. I know. I'm like, you with Joe? He's like, he in the back playing basketball. I'm like, nah, we can't go in the back because if I miss him, you know, I wasted all this time. Let's go. Let's go. Roll with me. We ran down to the train station, caught the train right when it was there. He was like, I ain't had no papers when we was going. I'm like, I'm going to pick up money. We went down there, we got in the studio, we did the background, we did this and this and that. Then I asked him, yo, you want to rap? And he was like, yo, don't do that shit you be doing, man. Don't do that. It's the first deal, don't do that. I'm like, yo, these dudes ain't really paying no money anyway. It ain't about them. It's about us being around from around the way. You want to rap? And he said, yeah. So I told the engineer he going to help me say something. He said, we ain't have no tracks open. Go over one of mine. But X laid his vocals down on all the way through it. He played like back-to-back thing and all that. He was like, now you do it. I was like, nah, I like it like that. Mm. When the record company came back from lunch, they listened to it and they had a fit. Like, who's the other guy? I'm like, that's my partner. They're like, we ain't got him. What is he doing? I'm like, we down. Like, you just can't do that, Jello. This is the record business. We ain't got no contract going there. Then give him one. we don't have no extra money. Yeah, really wasn't paying me that much money anyway. I split mine with his. Oh, Jalil, you just can't do that. Why not? You just said you liked it. I think you're making no more of this a headache than it needs to be. And he's like, you don't understand. I got to call the president of the company now. And he went and called him and came back in 20 minutes and said, he said, okay. He said he'll match me point for point. Every point I give up, he'll give another one to us. He said he never seen nobody give up their points for a partner. You know, it was all about, we did something together. Let me still pay you back for sticking with me, my man. You know, I'm down with that type of vibe, you know.
And yeah. What song was that you guys first recorded there?
Magic Swan.
Oh, it was just a proper studio version of Magic Swan.
Yes. We did it in 2 days, you know, after they sent Magic to tape. It was done.
Jalil, like, that type of loyalty and that type of wherewithal to bring your friend and the guy who helped get you on into the game is, man, there's no words for something that beautiful.
It's an amazing thing. Yes, so we gotta
wrap it up.
We gotta wrap it up, unfortunately. But hey, Ja, I will see you.
Yes, yes.
On the 26th.
Yes, yes.
At Atlantucky.
Atlantucky in Atlanta. Get your tickets at nationalhiphopmuseum.com. Jalil, thank you so much for talking to us today.
Thank you.
We look forward to honoring you on the 26th.
Thank you so much.
One love,
fam.
One love.
Peace. I'm not going to lie. You can't cut off somebody who is telling
you can't do the gems.
Like, priceless. Like, this is stuff
that we'll find other things to delete. Yeah. We're not deleting that.
Not at all.
No, we are going right into...
Give me that beat, fool. It's a full-time jack move.
Damn.
Damn, son. Where'd you get that?
Let's do it.
Go.
So, yeah, man. So, like I said, we got the legendary Whodini. They're one of the groups that have been privileged enough to be sampled. Like, their music was so hot and so influential
and so dominant. Too, though.
Right, exactly. Yeah. You know, with Larry Smith and everything, rest in peace once again.
Yeah.
You know, so a lot of people came behind them, and they are a source of samples for many other hit records.
Yes.
So I'm gonna deal with them today. One of their biggest records was this record called Friends. Woo. Definition of classic hip hop right here.
Man.
Friends, how many of us have them? Friends.
But a lot of legendary acts came behind them and sourced this song for their record. Some of them were album cuts that had influence, and some of them were big hits. So I'm gonna run through those real quick.
Okay.
Not sure if y'all remember a group. As a matter of fact, we got a box to my left with a guy named Flavor Flav, a guy named Chuck D, Terminator X.
Public Enemy?
Yes, sir.
Really?
This is off of Yo Bum Rush the Show. Sophisticated.
So, woman in the corner cold playing a role. Leave her ass in the corner till her feet gets cold. Knowing for a fact that girl is whack. If you hold your hand out, she'll turn on back. Better walk, don't talk. She's
well, you know, that's a New York act right there. That's like a classic New York record.
Chuck D.
But we go to the West Coast, and we get my man with the hat, with the chronic on it. This is off the Dr. Dre's first solo album.
Only four reasons come to mind. Why your mom with a brother is hard to find. You've been walking on the streets of
with
my mind.
This is one of the hardest records I've ever heard in my life. It is not friendly. That's the funny thing about it. It's the antithesis to the original song.
They totally changed the integrity of it.
This is called an N-word with a gun.
Wow.
Looking y'all remember the next one I'm gonna rock. Y'all remember this one because it rocked for a whole two summers right here.
Oh yeah.
Oh yeah. So this one interpolated two Whodini songs. So the drum break is based on Friends. And the groove is based on One Love. Imagine smoking weed in the
street without cops harassing. Wow. And shout out Larry Smith, who produced Friends. One of the greatest. Another one of the greatest producers. Larry Pumpkin Smith. And Larry Smith had Larry incredible Smith. Impacts on hip hop. Rest in peace to both of them.
That I wish that I had a chance to do. I never got a chance to work with him directly. And that was one of the things that I really did.
Rest in peace.
But check it out. Same year, right? Another legend from New York. We're repping the West Coast. Also dropped this one right here. So y'all remember Tupac? Y'all know Tupac?
I think I might have heard of him.
You ain't heard of him? He's a pretty good rapper.
Yeah, my bad. He's not one bad. He went bad from what I heard.
Unfortunately, a lot of these brothers ain't here with us no more. Like Tupac no longer here with us, you know. And the last one I'ma rock is another artist who's to my left as well, but he ain't here with us.
As you call them, they call you when they need some trees for the
peace,
blood,
MF,
to
cheese
for the front. I found a way to get peace of mind for years.
The legacy of Whodini is so
totally
crazy.
Totally.
Considering that I just dropped maybe like 5 or 6 tracks by
just that
all
quick.
Legends.
Yeah. Just that quick. Yeah.
That needed a slice of that Friends from Whodini. So.
Well, I'm telling you, this thing gets so crazy. But we've run out of time.
We have run out of time.
It goes too quickly.
It goes way too fast.
I want to let everybody know that if you want more information about attending Jalil and Whodini's induction, you can just go to @NationalHipHopMuseum on Instagram, and there's tons of info. The tickets are on Eventbrite. We're out of time. G wants to read it, but we're not going to because we have
no
time.
I can't read it even though I want to. I'm the MASTERGEE at Lantucky, August 26th, Slick Rick, Cool G Rap, Whodini, UTFO, Chub Rock. And we love you, and thanks for listening, and we'll see you next week in the Master G's Theater.
One love.